Hello, my name is Scream, and welcome back to Hard to Final 4 with Kaiser Remote as United States of America. So, let's continue with our game, and it's terrible. Stability is non-existent, war support is non-existent, our popularity is basically non-existent. Political power is gone. At least we have six divisions. Yucatan is invading United States of United Mexican States. So many things are happening. At least construction level 1 has been researched. Now let's research support weapons level 1. 132 days, so 3 researches will be finished at the same time. Manuel Carles assumes full control of Argentina. Oh, Argentina! Your demilitarized zone is huge. I think I will be playing as Argentina next. Okay, maybe not next, but I think I will want to play as Argentina. There is a Patagonian workers front. This is huge demilitarized zone. How many troops Argentina has? Well, a lot of troops in a very small place. Violence against politicians, we are losing political power, which sucks. We don't have political power and we are losing it. Playing against Brazil could be fun too. Whatever if players Brazil. Question is, do they have new focus tree? Battle of the overpass. In Detroit, Michigan, the automotive capital of the world, Walter Reuter and Richard Frankenstein, the leaders of the United Auto Workers Association, called a general strike against Ford Motor Company and proclaimed themselves for the unionism, not Fordism, demanding higher pay and fewer hours for automotive workers. At 2 p.m. today, a photographer from Detroit Free Press asked to take a photo of the leaders of the UAW standing on the overpass with Ford sign in the background. While they were posing, a group of 40 men from the Ford Service Department approached them from behind and began to beat them with their batons. The group then continued their attack on some of the beret-wearing women present to pass out leaflets. So we are in Sabati, which we don't have already, or which we don't have at all. Violence between SPA and AFP, Socialists and American First. So stability goes down, minus 28%. How low our stability can get before there will be civil war? Let's guess. Will we get to minus 50%? So with our current production, we gonna have enough fighters in 700 days. No, we not. We won't. 1200 days. Tactical bombers. 3000 days. Infantry equipment. 155 days. Well, that's out of days. I think 100 fighters will be enough. Or you know what? Let's get 150 fighters. Anyone's planes get here to Maryland because we will probably. You know what your job will be to do this. When war will happen, let's be ready to do air superiority in mid-Atlantic. Also, New England is here. So that means New England will have this land. So New York and New York City will be in our hands. As well as Pennsylvania and I'm pretty sure Maryland will stay in our hands. Indochina requests independence. Okay, no war, Panama. I could really use puppet here. Panama, how many military factories and civilian factories you have? 1 and 2. Well, still would be quite useful. Special election in New Jersey. Following a senator Following Senator A. Harry Moore's resignation in order to run for governor, a special election has been called in New Jersey to select his replacement. The frontrunner are Democrat John Gerald Milton and AFP Vice Chair Charles Lindbergh. Polls have just closed and the winner appears to be... Let's go with Democrats. I know we are Republicans, but I don't want to... I don't want American First Party to win. I at least want to try defend and keep United States together. But we will see. I will definitely save this game in like December. No, December is late. November are elections, well, in theory, elections. We can help them or they are on their own. You know what, let's help Liberia. Why not? Let's hope they won't join Germany. So you know what, in November I'm gonna save this game, if I will remember that. If not, well, then I'm not gonna save. And maybe later I can play as AFP or as Socialist Party of America, SPA. AFP, SPA. We will see as whom we're gonna play. November 1936, yeah. Elections. So 55 days and then we will have our researches done. You are missing stuff. We are missing inventory equipment. Well, we are missing a lot of stuff. Matter of factory, you gonna be... Oh, freaking kidding me. We went from 27 factories to 8. Construction speed minus 58%. This is ridiculous. How many 7 factories do we have? 111 consumer good factories. People expect 85% of our total number of factories to produce consumer goods. Well, people are stupid. Ranches push in Netherlands. Well, screw that. Who knows what's happening in Netherlands? But Yucatan is definitely invading United Mexican States. Okay, could be fun to play as Yucatan. To conquer all of United States. Conquer all of United Mexican States. And then all of this. And then all of America. Like, let's be honest, they don't have any division. So if we would attack like Guatemala as Yucatan, you could send few divisions to America and win. Pretty easily. And because AI is stupid, they would keep one army here. And probably one army here. They may recall them. But still, it would take a long time and until then America would have three divisions in here. So could be interesting. It's Yucatan. I still hate it. Haiti and Dominican Republic don't have their own focus trees. Like there's always war between those two, and I still have no idea why. Oh, something changed. This is not the demilitarized zone or anymore. And this one's not the demilitarized zone either. But let's be honest. In all purposes, this... Oh, demilitarized zones are changing. But still, for all purposes, this is the demilitarized zone because army has no way to get there. Unless like Chile will give military access, or Paraguay and Brazil, or Uruguay. I think the demilitarized zone is slowly being removed from Argentina. Argentinian government is doing something. 10 days! Now 8! Now 9! We are gaining 0.95 political power. We Weekly change, minus 0.3%, so our sovereignty still goes down. Our war support also goes down by 1% every week. So in 2 weeks, it will be 0%. Our armies are still being trained. So, election is here. Oh, it's November already. Let's save that. Election. The results are finally in. From what has been the most ideologically contested presidential election the United States have ever witnessed. None of the four major parties have secured enough votes in electoral college to outright win the presidency. And as a result, the House of Representatives once again has to vote on the winner of the election. This is probably not the end of our problems, but for the time being, victory goes to... Alf London! Let's do that! So our popularity is now 43%, 22%. Alf London was a successful entrepreneur in the oil business long before his entry into politics. This self-started led to the creation of the United States Oil and Gas Association, a lobbying group that London remained attached to this day. What initially seemed like a poor decision to break with Hoover in favor of interventionist economic policies turned to his advantage when the Republican Party came with him. Now, despite his humble demeanor, London has proven to be the soft voice of confident recovery that America wanted in the election. Although his strong ties with the oil lobby makes him enemy of both socialists and longists. Well, we'll see what's gonna happen. Probably civil war. 1946, what do we want to research? Definitely radio. Interval artillery, and let's go with better planes, I guess. Yeah. Let's get Curtis P-36 Hawk. I don't think Panama will be invading anyone. So I'm gonna send our... not you, not here, not this. I'm gonna send an army here, just so we can get that population attack bonus. And so at least some part of farming will get it. SPA contest election results. The leadership of the Socialist Party of America have refused to accept the results of our free and fair election, claiming that the electoral college system has subverted the will of the majority. Damn read. And damn wrong. Bastards. -40% stability. Yes, sir. Guys, oh, we have planes here. We have planes here. Delete. Do we have more planes? Good question. I have no idea. Let's hope not. You know what? Guys, can you merge together? Get to New York, all of you. Oh. Atlantic. All of you get to Newark. If you can, if not, screw you. Oh no, get to New York. Hoover criticized the president. Herbert Hoover was vocal after the election and openly criticized Reed and the SPA as being unfit to lead country. Hoover has encouraged the Republicans and Democrats to form an alliance to curb Reed and SPA. It doesn't matter. You guys, merge together and we have US and Atlantic Battle Fleet. We have two carriers, so that's nice, that's okay. Let's Let's get more murder factories. And finally we have 11 cement factories. Okay, construction speed went down by 67%. Yeah, because of our stability, which still goes down. Welcome to production. Oh, we're gonna have enough infantry equipment soon. And those guys will be deployed soon, too. Combat wave 14. Well, I'm gonna keep you. And we're gonna have enough infantry equipment in when? 90 days, so that's getting closer too. Slowly and steadily slowly and steadily we are producing more infantry equipment. 50 days and grand battle plan will be finished. Max planning will be increased by 10%. Well, let's hope it's gonna be useful and good and everything which we need to succeed in our civil war, future civil war. Okay, research, focus, well, no focus. We are still not focusing on anything. We want that positive political power so we can actually choose some leader of our army or something. Anything else? Like some civil war in somewhere else? Yeah, that. Oh, America. I totally forgot about that. Mexican Yucatan War, so let's see. How's that changing? A New Year's Day strike for who knows how long. Probably until end of the game. And a spirit. Production efficiency cap minus 70%, factory output minus 17%. Screw those guys. Like, we don't have equipment, and now we will be getting even less equipment. What can we do? Well, nothing. What can we do? No, nothing. We can do anything. We cannot do anything. Maybe then, maybe after the civil war will be over, or will start. Hopefully. Or are we gonna be lucky and we will avert that civil war? I have no idea what we would have to do. Alf London's inauguration address. Alf London was sworn in as 31st President of the United States of America today. At his inaugural address, he spoke of the challenges facing the nation and how we can overcome them together. Whenever anyone will listen, is another matter. At least we are getting political power, and soon we're gonna have positive political power. Which means soon we're gonna get some event which will lower our political power. Canada, what's your army size? Well, Canada's big. I think President deals with strike. Let's propose this bill, let's see what's gonna happen. Like, I haven't played as Canada yet. Return of the King. Why not? Yeah, we could play as Canada. Return home to British Isles. To make empire which never sleeps. It passes. So maybe this strike will be a vote. People arrested, leaders arrested. Thrown into prison. So, are we gonna have enough infantry equipment in 236 days? Well, that sucks. Reed calls London a tool of Wall Street. Damn you, Reed. We are losing political power. No, we are not losing the political power. I'm surprised. but our force support is basically non-existent. Yulong caused land corrupt, well, bastard. And yet we are getting 250% of our stability, so... Let's see. It still goes down by 0.1. Soon, our stability will actually go up. Meet with Long and Reed. In response to the ongoing crisis, Alf London has proposed to meet down with both Yulong and Jack Reed and try to get some sort of compromise. However, some are saying within the Republican Party that this plan of action will not work. Well, arrange conference, let's see what's gonna happen. Like, no one wants civil war. Let's see what those guys will want. And if we would be smart, we would arrest them. For whatever reason. In 23 days, our two researches will be done. Oh, send in National Guard, or we will send National Guard. The CSA has been aggravating the workers in the area to expand the strike. Local businesses were paralyzed and many of them turned to the America First Party to provide a solution. Within days, the streets were flooded with American First ducks. Soon the situation had erupted into a widespread riot. Let's send in National Guard. I will send army there. Those 9 divisions we have, I would send them there. I would send them in. So 19 days and then our research will be done. And in like 40 days we're gonna have positive power. No, it's gonna be sooner. So we're like in 25 days. Send in more forces! National Guard commander in St. Louis was overwhelmed by the amount of violence in the city. Battle in St. Louis became war zone as all sides fell upon each other. The National Guard was overwhelmed. Let's send more forces. So how long until we will send army there? Liberia declares independence. Well, I didn't knew that Liberia was not independent. I don't really care about them. Oh, they cannot escape so easily. While Liberia has been protectorate of the United States until now, this changed after a totalist government came to power in a coup. And they have declared their independence and banished all American advisors from their government. There are concerns over the safety of American citizens remaining in Liberia. As far as matter of national pride at stake. But is it truly even worth the cause of reprisal? They have rubber! Yeah, they cannot escape so easily. Will that casus belli disappear? Nope, yeah, great, no problem. We can deal with them after our civil war. If it will happen. Maybe we're gonna look lucky and we're gonna avert it. Then we can actually do stuff with our focuses. St. Louis becomes a war zone. The troops that arrived to support the National Guard found themselves in a war zone. As people streamed out of St. Louis, the federal forces tried to wrest control of the city with little success. Each side became involved in one pitched battle after another. And it was war that had not yet been declared, but that would soon change. Well, situation now self control. So where is St. Louis? Here! Long declares the American Union state. Hugh Long has declared the president London is a tyrant and must be opposed. In radio speech, he denounced him for being in league with the syndicalists of the SAP and accused him of doing nothing to stop the chaos. Long has vowed to restore order and destroy corrupt government in Washington. He will stand by the Republic. Are we at war with them? Nope. Ships, be ready. We're gonna definitely do search and destroy. We will blockade those guys. Redeclare the second American Revolution. The crackdown on Socialist Party would have only one outcome. To protect the rights of workers across the nation, Jack Reed has announced The creation of combined syndicates of America with him as president, and has vowed to free the rest of America from their capitalist overlords. Disaster has begun. Stand by America. Forgive me! We actually lost this? Damn it. Can we actually get to Washington? In time. No! It's too soon! No civil war yet. I'm not clicking that. Our army is not in position to actually do anything. Well, when I say army, I mean those 9 divisions, which will be quite useless. Guys, be aggressive. Let's be honest. Be aggressive. So we're gonna lose Great Depression, New York strike, and political crisis. We're gonna get 200 political power. That's awesome. Set base number to 55%. That will be nice. That's really nice too. What? You got actually lost? Okay, I didn't expect that. Guys, so wars happened. Throughout the country, a number of men have risen up, loyal to the federal government. So we are now at war, and the people want to give us stuff, and I will accept French stuff. We have 37 factories. In that case, let's produce more stuff in our country. Well, let's not do stuff in New York. Probably not Carolina. Oh, screw it. Let's do that. Doesn't matter. Now, we have unassigned divisions. Let's create a new army. 54 divisions, I like that. So we have 16 divisions here. What are you doing here? Guys, seriously, get here. And yeah, get down here. I'm gonna take you guys, attack. Well, I'm gonna take you, move here. What if you move here? 11, 16, that's not enough. No, we have militia. 11, so we need 13 divisions. Guys, join here. I'm gonna make this red army a little bit bigger. Now, we have 39 divisions. I'm gonna split this in half. I'm gonna create a new army. You're gonna be blue. How many divisions do you have? Too many. You're gonna be led by this guy. You're gonna be blue, guys. Your orders are to get here. Okay, your orders are to get here, so you can actually survive. I'm gonna take 3 of you, get here. And we still have 6. Okay, I'm gonna take 1 of you, get here. Now, Syndicates of America, how many divisions you... What the hell are you doing here? Just get out. Okay, Syndicates, how many divisions do you have? So that it doesn't matter. I'm gonna take 15 of you. You're gonna have new army. You will be led by... Patton, yeah. You're gonna be led by Patton. Your color is gonna be yellow, and I'm gonna send you... Be here. So, our army is time because now AI will move immediately? Okay, I'm surprised. Usually they wait until their professional bonus is at maximum. So I'm kinda surprised. Oh, you cannot. Red army, you can attack. Just attack. Attack everywhere. Attack everywhere and Evan, you guys stop that. Horse. Get to Pittsburgh and Cleveland. It would be nice if we could cut... There's Second American Civil War. Territories of Hawaii. Revolt. Place Hawaii. Well, we should have expected this. American mission in the Philippines. Let's recall the units. People or stability. Let's get stability. We have manpower. We need stability. Panama aggression. People will return home. I don't really care. You're not doing anything. Get to Yellow Army. Okay, when are you gonna get to Mobile or to this naval base? In 11 days. Well, hopefully we'll survive there. Syndicalists, what the hell are you doing here? Okay, doesn't matter. I don't care about those troops. Guys, what the hell? Just idiots, get out! Idiots, retreat! You won't be fighting here. Your orders are clear. Get here and there, this area you can defend. Well, if you will get there in time to actually move. Okay, change your plans, guys. You are kinda screwed, so be here. Yellow Army, you still can get there if you will get there. Chief of Air Force, Carl Andrew Spatz. Bombers, I don't really care. Battlefield, bomb. Carver bombing doctrine. Close air support agility plus 3%, I like that. And you know what? Those guys will die. Okay, how long until we'll arrive here? This division is dead. Now, unfortunately, nothing we can do about that. Those guys are dead. I'm not surprised. Those guys are trying to get to here. Well, let's see if how they're gonna be successful. You know what? I mean you. Get here and then move to Houston. We definitely need to defend this naval base. So Blue Army can actually get here. Red Army, see that you kinda need bigger front line, just a little bit. Maybe like this big front line. And is there anyone else like Red Army, Blue Army, Yellow Army? Nope, just you. You know what? You are now part of Red Army. So Philadelphia is in our hands. 1947, okay, finally, let's research dispersed industry. And construction. So what military factories we are building? We are definitely not in Missouri. 40%. Okay, let's build. No. Let's hope that Pacific States of America won't happen. We will be building military factories there. Okay, screw you, Pennsylvania. Okay, Low Army, your front line is kinda sucks. Okay, Yellow Army, new orders. This is your front line, at least for now. Blue and yellow, you can actually attack. Yellow, you definitely run. If those two will be fighting each other, I'm okay with that. But for now, let's focus on one enemy. For now, we must. Oh, freaking kidding me! You are the thing. Oh, nope! You stop this! Get here! We must defend this port. Oh no! Relieve civilian suffering. hardship of civil war. We must support our troops, like screw people. Well, I don't want to say screw them, but well. What can we do? Guys, maybe it would be nice if you would actually attack, like, and did something. Yeah, I think this civil war is going in our favor. Oh, frack. Those three divisions, those four divisions are dead. So, Chief of Army. Eisenhower, army experience will go up, also playing speed and loss organizational loss when moving will go down. Division attack, I like that. Organizations consumption, let's hire Kenneth George Adhus. What the hell, guys? Where are you going? Get here, you idiot! Like, I don't mind your way, but definitely go around. AI, are you freaking stupid or what? Get here. This way, this is your, those are your orders. No one's here, go take Cheyenne. You take this province. You move here. You know what? You take this province. No, you move here. You take those provinces here. Those three provinces here. Oh, frack. Nope, strategically redeploy here. Okay, here. And then move here. Can we get... No one is defending this province. This sucks. Okay, you guys. You need to defend. Yo, you free! Attack Antonio! Nicora declares Monroe dead. Well, screw them. Like now, right now we have our own problems. Like, Washington is still in our hands. We lost Philadelphia. Well, that's unfortunate. And those guys are kinda losing. Okay, not really losing, but they are dying. Outdated equipment in production, well... We don't have factories to actually produce anything, so... Okay, let's finish this episode here, and in between of episodes I will look how... what can we do. Obviously not much. I will probably send this Red Army here. It's terrible, but right now we cannot survive here. Yeah, I think I'm gonna have to do it. But for now, let's finish this episode here. If you enjoyed this episode, please continue watching and have a nice rest of your day. Goodbye.